Hello everyone, welcome to the lecture video of System Software and Compilers Module 2. In this lecture, we will be looking at specification of tokens and recognition of tokens. Specification of tokens. Regular expressions are an important notation for specifying lexeme patterns. While they cannot express all possible patterns, but they are very effective in specifying those type of patterns that we actually need for tokens. Now we shall see the formal notation for regular expressions. An alphabet is any finite set of symbols. Typical examples of symbols are letters, digits, and punctuation. The set 01 is the binary alphabet. ASCII is an important example of an alphabet. It is used in many software systems. A string over an alphabet is a finite sequence of symbols drawn from that alphabet. In language theory, the terms sentence and word are often used as synonyms for string. The length of a string is usually written as a modulus of s is the number of occurrences of symbols in S. For example, apple is a string of length 5. The empty string denoted by epsilon is the string of length 0. Language. A language is any countable set of strings over some fixed alphabet. This definition is very broad. Abstract languages like null, empty set, or epsilon, or the set containing only the empty string, are languages under this definition. Now let us see some string related terms that are commonly used. A prefix. A prefix of a string S is any string obtained by removing zero or more symbols from the end of S. For example, BAN, BANANA, and epsilon are prefixes of banana. Suffix. A suffix of a string S is any string obtained by removing zero or more symbols from the beginning of S. For example, NANA, BANANA, and epsilon are suffixes of banana. Substring. A substring of S is obtained by deleting any prefix and any suffix from S. For instance, BANANA, NAN, and epsilon are the substring of the string banana. The proper prefixes, suffixes, and substrings of a string S are those prefixes, suffixes, and substrings respectively of S that are not epsilon or not equal to S itself. Subsequence. Subsequence of yes is any string formed by deleting zero or more, not necessarily the consecutive positions of yes. For example, BAAN is a subsequence of the string banana. Operations on languages. In lexical analysis, the most important operations on languages are union, concatenation, and closure, which are defined formally, are shown. Union is the familiar operation on sets. The concatenation of languages is all strings formed by taking a string from the first language and a string from second language in all possible ways and concatenating them. The Lean's closure of language L, denoted L raised to star, is the set of strings you get by concatenating L zero or more times. L raised to zero is the concatenation of L zero times and is defined to be the epsilon. And inductively, L raised to I is L raised to I minus L. Finally, the positive closure, denoted L raised to plus, is the same as the Lean's closure, but without the term L raised to 0. That is, epsilon will not be in L plus unless it is in L itself. Regular expressions. We are able to describe identifiers by giving names to sets of letters and digits and using the language operators union, concatenation, and closure. This process is useful that a notation called regular expressions has come into a common use for describing all the languages that can be built from these operators applied to the symbols of some alphabet. In this notation, if a letter is established to stand for any letter or the underscore, and digit underscore is established to stand for any digit, then we could describe the language of C identifiers by writing letter underscore followed by the parenthesis letter or digits in zero or more number of times. In the regular expression, the vertical bar means union. The parentheses are used to group sub-expressions, and star means zero or more occurrences of. The regular expressions are built recursively out of smaller regular expressions using the rules. Each regular expression R denotes language L of R, which is also defined recursively from the languages denoted by R's sub-expressions. Now we discuss the rules that define the regular expressions over some alphabet and the languages that those expressions denote. Regular expression over alphabet has following rules. Epsilon is a regular expression that is the set containing a empty string. A is a regular expression if A belongs to the alphabet that is a set containing the string A. Suppose R and S are a regular expression denoting the languages L of R and L of S, then R vertical bar S is a regular expression denoting the language L of R union L of S. R concatenated with S is a regular expression denoting the language L of R concatenated with L of S. R star is a regular expression denoting L of R raised to star. R is a regular expression denoting L of R. A language denoted by a regular expression is said to be a regular set where star, concatenation and or has highest to lowest precedence with left associativity. If two regular expressions R and S denote the same language, then we say that R and S are equivalent and we write R equals S. Let us see an example. Let alphabet is equal to A comma B. The regular expression A or B denotes the language A comma B. Here the strings are A and B. Another one is A or B followed by A or B denotes the language of all strings of length 2 over the alphabet, and those are denoted by AA, AB, BA, BB. And another regular expression for the same language is AA or AB or BA or BB. A star denotes the language consisting of all strings of 0 or more A's, that is epsilon, A, AA, AAA and so on. A or B whole star denotes the set of all strings consisting of 0 or more instances of A or B, that is all strings of A's and B's, epsilon, A, B, AA, AB, BA, BB, AAA and so on. Another regular expression for the same language can be A star, B star, whole raised to star. A or A star B denotes the language A, B, AB, AAB, AAAB, that is the string A and all strings consisting of 0 or more A's and ending in B. A language that can be defined by a regular expression is called a regular set. If two regular expressions R and S denote the same regular set, we say that they are equivalent and write R equals S. For instance, A or B equals B or A. There are a number of algebraic laws for regular expressions. Each law asserts that expressions of two different forms are equivalent. Figure shows some of the algebraic laws that hold for arbitrary regular expressions R, S and T. So the first law, R or S equals S or R. So R is commutative. R or S or T equals R or S or T is associative. R followed by ST is equal to RS followed by T. So concatenation is associative. R followed by S or T is equal to RS or RT. S or T followed by R equals SR or TR. So the concatenation distributes over R. Epsilon followed by R equals R followed by epsilon equals R. So epsilon is the identity for concatenation. R star equals R or epsilon whole raised to star. So epsilon is guaranteed in a closure. R double star equals R star. So star is here the idempotent. Similar to regular expressions, regular definitions also can be used for specification of tokens. Regular definition is a sequence of definitions of the form d1 derives r1, d2 derives r2 and so on up to d1 derives rn, where di is a distinct name and ri is a regular expression. For example, C identifiers are strings of letters, digits and underscores. Here is a regular definition for the language of C identifiers. Therefore, the specification of tokens is possible either through regular expression or regular definition. Recognition of token. Now let us see how to take the patterns for all the needed tokens and build a piece of code that examines the input string and finds a prefix that is a lexeme matching one of the patterns. As an intermediate step in the construction of a lexical analyzer, we first convert patterns into stylized flowcharts called transition diagrams. Transition diagrams have a collection of nodes or circles called states. Each state represents a condition that could occur during the process of scanning the input looking for a lexeme that matches one of several patterns. We may think of a state as summarizing all we need to know about what characters we have seen between the lexeme begin pointer and the forward pointer. Edges are directed from one state of the transition diagram to another. Each edge is labeled by a symbol or set of symbols. If we are in some state S and the next input symbol is A, we look for an edge out of the state S labeled by A. If we find such an edge, we advance the forward pointer and enter the state of the transition diagram to which that edge leads. We assume that all our transition diagrams are deterministic, meaning that there is never more than one edge out of a given state with a given symbol among its labels. Some important conventions about transition diagrams are certain states are said to be accepting or final. These states indicate that a lexeme has been found, although the actual lexeme may not consist of all positions between the lexeme begin and forward pointers. We always indicate an accepting state by a double circle, and if there is an action to be taken, typically returning a token and an attribute value to the parser, we shall attach that action to the accepting state. In addition, if it is necessary to retract the forward pointer one position, that is the lexeme does not include the symbol that got us to the accepting state, in that case we shall additionally place a star near the accepting state. In our example, it is never necessary to retract forward by more than one position, but if it were, we could attach any number of stars to the accepting state. One state is designated as the start state or initial state. It is indicated by an edge labeled start entering from nowhere. The transition diagram always begins in the start state before any input symbols have been read. Example: draw the transition diagram to recognize lexemes matching relational operator. Figure shows a transition diagram that recognizes the lexemes matching the token relational operator. We begin in state 0, the start state. If we see the less than symbol as the first input symbol, then among the lexemes that match the pattern for reloop, we can only be looking at less than, not equal to, or less than or equal to. We therefore go to state 1 and look at the next character. If it is equal to, then we recognize the lexeme less than or equal to and enter the state 2 and return the token reloop with the attribute less than or equal to, the symbolic constant representing this particular comparison operator. If in state 1 the next character is greater than symbol, then instead we have a lexeme not equal to, and enter the state 3 to return an indication that the not equal to operator has been found. On any other character, the lexeme is less than, and we enter the state 4 to return that information. However, the state 4 has a star to indicate that we must retract the input one position. On the other hand, if in state 0 the first character we see is equal to, then this one character must be the lexeme. We immediately returned that fact from the state file. The remaining possibility is that the first character is greater than symbol, then we must enter the state 6 and decide on the basis of the next character whether the lexem is greater than or equal to or just greater than. Then if in state 0 we see any characters besides less than, equal to or greater than, we cannot possibly be seeing a relational operator lexem. So this transition diagram will not be used. There are several ways that a collection of transition diagrams can be used to build a lexical analyzer. Regardless of the overall strategy, each state is represented by a piece of code. We may imagine a variable state holding the number of the current state for a transition diagram. A switch based on the value of a state takes us to the code for each of the possible states where we find the action of that state. Often the code for a state is itself a switch statement or multi-way branch that determines the next state by reading and examining the next input character. Getreloc is a C++ function whose job is to simulate the transition diagram for a relational operator and return an object of type token, that is a pair consisting of the token name and an attribute value. Getreloc function first creates a new object return token and initializes its first component to reloc, the symbolic code for the token relational operator. We see the typical behavior of a state in case 0, the case where the current state is 0. A function nextchar obtains the next character from the input and assigns it to the local variable c. We then check C for the three characters we expect to find, making the state transition dictated by the transition diagram of a relational operator in each case. For example, if the next input character is equal to, we go to state 5. If the next input character is not the one that can begin a comparison operator, then a function fail is called. What the function fail does depends on the global error recovery strategy of the lexical analyzer. It should reset the for pointer to lexem begin in order to allow another transition diagram to be applied to the true beginning of the unprocessed input. It might then change the value of state to be the start state for another transition diagram, which will search for another token. Alternatively, if there is no other transition diagram that remains unused, fail function could initiate an error correction phase that will try to repair the input and find a lexem. In the program, we also show the action for state 8 in figure, because state 8 bears a star, we must retract the input pointer by one position. The task is accomplished by the function retract. Since state 8 represents the recognition of lexem greater than or equal to, we set the second component of the returned object to GT, which is the code for this operator.